In this video, we're presented with a position time graph for a bug walking back and forth on a string, and we're asked to compute the average velocity on the time interval 0 to 6. So the answer here is really quick. The average velocity is given by the change in position divided by the change in time. And to find the change in position, it doesn't matter at all what's going on between the starting point and the finishing point. All that matters is what the final and initial position values are. And that final position value is 2 meters. The initial was 0. The final time was 6 seconds. The initial was 0. So we don't care about those zeros. And this reduces to 1/3 meters per second as a decimal of the 3 sig figs, 0.333 meters per second. Now, it's interesting to note a couple ways that you could get this question wrong. And one way that I've seen this go wrong is to compute the speed on the first segment of the journey. So that's where the bug moves 4 meters in 2 seconds. I'll call that V1. 4 meters in 2 seconds. So the bug was moving 2 meters per second for the first 2 seconds. Then you could look at the second branch and say, well, the bug moved 2 meters in the negative direction over 4 seconds. And again, this is the wrong path for solving the problem. But the result then would be found by averaging these two velocities or averaging these two speeds. And you just don't get the right answer from that. If you ignore the minus sign, you get 2 plus 0.5 over 2. And you get 1.25 meters per second. And that's not right. If you included the minus sign, you get 1.5 over 2, 0.75 meters per second. And that's not right. The other way I've seen this question answered incorrectly is to actually find the total distance traveled, which would be 4 meters in the positive direction, followed by 2 meters in the negative direction. So that's 6 meters of total distance. If you then divide by how long it took, you would get the sometimes useful quantity, average speed. That's distance over time. Total distance covered divided by how long it took. That gives you 6 meters over 6 seconds, which would give you 1 meter per second average speed. And unfortunately, that answer isn't right because what we were asked for in this problem was the average velocity. So we had to use displacement over time. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.